explosive. Hannity drops multiple bombs, blows the ore case wide open by US4Trump.com. Last night on Fox News, Sean Hannity, in a power-packed segment, rolled out detail after detail on the Bruce Ohr closed-door congressional testimony. It's no wonder Hannity is the most watched news program on cable television, as compared to CNN, who has dropped to the number 6 spot behind the History Channel. Sean continues to prop Fox News in its number 1 spot for the 200th consecutive month in a row with blockbuster interviews like his powerful monologue from last night. Who is Bruce Ohr? In his opening monologue, Hannity recanted for America. Now remember, Bruce Ohr is the twice demoted DOJ official who once helped ex-foreign spy paid for by Hillary, Christopher Steele, who spread all the anti-Trump Russia lies throughout the highest levels of our government. Sarah Carter reported that during the closed-door session, it was obvious earlier on that Bruce Ohr was the back channel for Steele. The FBI was using Ohr to get the dirty dossier dispersed throughout the intel community and used as the springboard for the FISA warrant, which was the springboard for the special counsel and the, quote, insurance policy to get Trump. Hannity told America after Ohr's deposition, Ohr said that the FBI knew everything and that they did nothing about it. FISA abuse happened. John Radcliffe here tweeted, in the 4 FISA applications I reviewed in their full unredacted form, Bruce Ohr's involvement with the Steele dossier was never disclosed. Tonight I'll join Sean Hannity on Fox News to discuss my questioning with Ohr about his connection to the Steele dossier. Specifically, the FBI did not pass the information along to the FISA court. Does this sound like the politicized FBI pulled a fast one on the FISA court? I still believe that Judge Contreras was in on it. That's why he recused himself. He was an Obama appointee. He didn't file any charges after the news came out that he was misled. So that leads me to believe that Contreras was in on it and he was an Obama appointee. Let's take a quick listen here. Maybe sooner than 12 minutes.
All right, tonight we are blowing this case about Bruce Ohr, FISA abuse, wide open. I've been on the phone with sources all day and all night, people who were in the room during Ohr's testimony. We did learn today that Bruce Ohr said that he understood the Steele dossier would never have been accepted in a court of law. He understood it. You have 65 pages of notes and texts and then meetings between him and Christopher Steele. He said the FBI knew about the seedy relationship with Steele. So much to cover. Stay with us. We'll break it wide open. But there's no doubt that a conspiracy to commit fraud against FISA court judges did in fact take place. Now let's dive into the testimony from Bruce Ohr today. Now remember, he is the twice demoted DOJ official who once helped ex-foreign spy, paid for by Hillary, Christopher Steele, spread all these anti-Trump Russian lies throughout the highest levels of our government. And today, during a closed-door hearing, Bruce Ohr was grilled on the Hill by members of the House Oversight and the Judiciary Committees for 7 hours. Now, the crucial issue at play here is rampant FISA abuse surrounding Christopher Steele's dirty dossier with Russian lies that Hillary Clinton illegally funneled through a law firm into Fusion GPS hiring then Christopher Steele. Now, our sources say that that topic was front and center at the hearing today. Get this. Sarah Carter is now reporting, she'll join us later, that we now know that the FBI was aware of Steele's blatant and extreme anti-Trump bias before they used his dossier as the bulk of their FISA court applications. Remember, Bruce Ohr even wrote Steele was, quote, desperate that Donald Trump not get elected. He was passionate that Donald Trump not being president of the United States. Sounds just like Carter, just like Page and Strzok. And Sarah Carter also reporting that today's hearing proved that the FBI was using Bruce Ohr as a back channel for Steele's anti-Trump intel, even after the FBI cut all formal ties with Christopher Steele over trust issues. And he's saying that the FBI knew everything. And despite this, Congressman John Ratcliffe, who was a part of today's hearing, is telling us that Orr was not mentioned in any of the FBI FISA applications against the Trump campaign associate. Now, Congressman Ratcliffe, Sarah Carter, Greg Jarrett, and John Solomon will all be with us tonight. This is yet another sign of the FBI's blatant effort to hide the true nature of Clinton's bought and paid for Steele's dirty Russian dossier. It was campaign op research. It was compromised. It was never verified or corroborated. It turned out to be lies, Russian lies, funded by the Clinton campaign and the DNC. They funneled the money through a law firm, hiring Fusion GPS, that then hired Christopher Steele, an ex-foreign spy that had really seedy Russian connections, we now know, who was working with and for Fusion GPS. And by the way, it was also on the FBI payroll. This is really the cherry on the top. He was working with Bruce Orr's wife, Nellie Orr. The Orrs were literally profiting off their relationship with Christopher Steele. Orr said today that he disclosed that to the FBI. Really? And the FBI was okay with that? Now, at the end, this is where we are. We now know for a fact that in four separate FISA court applications, FISA court judges were repeatedly lied to, knowingly lied to. The American people, you were all lied to, all in an effort by high-ranking government bureaucrats to steal, sway, rob an election, and at all costs stop Donald Trump from winning and then to destroy his presidency. Now, communications between Orr and Christopher Steele, 60-some-odd pages of it, it shows that Steele was extremely concerned about being exposed for this and for good reason, because this level of corruption and abuse should make every single American citizen sick. A blatant example of what I've been telling you, a two-tier justice system. Hillary Clinton gets a free pass. Trump is literally targeted by our government with her salacious, phony campaign op research put together by a foreign national using Russian sources for lies. We have a brand new article tonight from Greg Jarrett. He'll be with us too. He details how the one-time FBI director, James Comey, took control of the Clinton investigation, took it right out of the hands of the field offices, and twisted the facts, softened the language, exonerated Clinton, rigged her investigation from the very beginning. There really never was an investigation. Clinton was never going to be found guilty because she was the favored candidate. And meanwhile, the FBI, the Department of Justice, they worked hand in hand with ex-foreign spy Christopher Steele to use his phony lies to open an investigation into allegedly Trump-Russia collusion. They gained these FISA warrants illegally against a Trump campaign associate. They potentially leaked that information, we know they leaked it, to the general public to sway opinion with lies. This is the stuff that happened in the former Soviet Union. All of this despite everybody knowing, including Orr admitting today, that Steele's shady past, that his work for the Clinton campaign, that his blatant bias against Trump, that his leaks to the press, that he was let go by the FBI that was also paying him. It's no wonder President Trump keeps talking about a witch hunt, and he's living with his attorney general. Mr. Sessions, where are you tonight? Why are you standing by and literally doing nothing to fix what is clearly a horrific inequality in our justice system? Now today, Senator Lindsey Graham, he summed it up best. Let's take a look.
Word of caution, public. A lot of people have tried to convict President Trump. Don't be so fast. I've seen no evidence of collusion after 2 years. Mueller's looking at it. We'll see what he says. Plenty of corruption. Department of Justice and the FBI should be stunning. Not one Democrat seems to care. Reverse the roles.
What corruption? What do you mean?
Okay, just imagine if the Republican Party had hired a foreign agent to go to Russia to get dirt on Hillary Clinton, and they used it to get a warrant and never told the court about it. It'd be a front page story everywhere. That's pretty corrupt when the two FBI agent and the U.S. attorney, the DOJ lawyer, it's our job to stop Trump. Can you imagine what would happen if it's our job to stop Clinton?
Now, we have a lot of breaking news tonight right here in this program. In other words, we do have news to break as it relates to Russian collusion. It's been found. I know Robert Mueller cares about taxicab medallions and old income tax reports and loan applications. Maybe Mr. Mueller should take note of what we're reporting tonight, because we have a new report from John Solomon. Follow the bouncing ball. Bruce Orr, the DOJ, closely working with a Putin-linked Russian oligarch for years. And most recently, the FBI tried to squeeze the oligarch for information surrounding Trump-Russia collusion, including a theory that Paul Manafort was leading Trump campaign's collusion efforts. By the way, he'd been into a lawsuit with Paul Manafort, and even he said that's ridiculous, it's absurd. And according to Solomon, the oligarch actually used the word preposterous. Now think about this. This is the same Russian oligarch that the U.S. won't even allow into the country. He met with Bruce Orr. He met with other top officials. You've got to be kidding me. How much more insane does this get? You cannot make this up.
No.
We reached out to Orr, the DOJ, the Russian oligarch involved. Of course, we didn't get a response. We're going to have a lot more on all of these issues. All of the key players are joining us tonight. But meanwhile, the biggest cheerleader of Trump-Russia collusion has been caught red-handed yet again, reporting fake news to you, the American people. In July, fake news CNN, they broke a huge bombshell story detailing shocking evidence about Trump's involvement in the now infamous 2016 Trump Tower meeting. We've got the tape to remind you.
Well, Chris, tonight, sources with knowledge tell myself and Carl that Michael Cohen claims that then-candidate Donald Trump knew in advance about the June 2016 meeting in Trump Tower in which Russians were expected to offer his campaign dirt on Hillary Clinton. Crucially, these sources tell us that Cohen is willing to make that assertion to the special counsel, Robert Mueller.
It's very, very significant because the president has denied any foreknowledge of this event, and this meeting goes to the question of intent to collude.
You've been saying for a year that we need to follow the money, follow the lies, and figure out this cover-up. So how did you do it in this case? Talk to us about how you got this reporting.
Well, I talked to sources. Cohen was saying that Donald Trump, the candidate for president of the United States at the time, had authorized the go-ahead for that meeting to take place with his son.
More Humpty Dumpty CNN fake news. And according to BuzzFeed, one of the unnamed sources in the report was Cohen attorney Lanny Davis. He's now completely backtracking on his claims to fake news CNN. He says that his client, in fact, does not have information of Trump's knowledge of the 2016 Trump Tower meeting. He's saying that CNN's anonymous sources, including himself, we were wrong. And after all, Michael Cohen testified under oath. This is all coming out, that he had no knowledge of Trump's involvement in that meeting or anything else. And we also have a new wrinkle in the story. When CNN published their, quote, bombshell report, they wrote that Lanny Davis declined to comment in an article where he was the primary source. That's fake news at its worst. Now, tonight, CNN is actually laughably standing by that horribly flawed story. Spokesperson even said to us, they are confident in their phony reporting. It seems like a perfect story for some members, media reporters at CNN, but I guess they're probably too busy watching this show every night because they can't even watch their fake news network and their own terrible reporting that comes from them every day.
Mm-hmm.
Now, the debacle surrounding Lanny Davis is just the latest in a long line of faulty reporting from fake news CNN. 2017, three CNN employees resigned after a fake story about our friend Anthony Scaramucci. A few months later, CNN was slammed and publicly embarrassed over a fake report about Donald Trump Jr. And let's never forget CNN's fake reporting over President Trump. Remember when he was with the Japanese prime minister and they were feeding the fish?
Yeah.
Since the very moment Donald Trump announced his run for office, CNN has been blinded by their hatred.
Yep.
And now while the network ramps up this crazy rhetoric and faulty reporting to destroy the president, the country's actually improving by leaps and bounds. Stock market breaking new records. We're seeing historic low levels of unemployment in 14 states. African Americans, Hispanic Americans, women in the workforce, youth unemployment, a 52-year low. And now we have more great news that they'll never report. Consumer confidence today closing at an 18-year high. So much more good news to report on the economic front.
Well, very true. Unbelievable. You can't make this stuff up. Bottom line, that's it. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. And again, thank you so much for watching.